Así que nos va a enviar su Biblia en el libro de Primera de Samuel. En el capítulo 15, versículo 22. Si usted no tiene la Biblia, aquí en la pantalla, pondremos la escritura. Primera de Samuel, capítulo 15, versículo 22. Y le voy a pedir a todos los niños que pasen al cuarto de la derecha para que ellos tengan su clase de iglesia de niños. Gloria sea al Señor, ¿verdad? Sus hijos de menor de 10 años, pásenle para que ellos puedan aprender de la palabra de Dios. Queremos, ¿verdad?, que todos puedan recibir la palabra del Señor. Bueno, así mismo vamos a leer la palabra del Señor. Y dice la palabra del Señor en el nombre del Padre, y del Hijo y del Espíritu Santo. Y Samuel dijo: ¿tiene Jehová tanto contentamiento con los holocaustos y víctimas como en obedecer a las palabras de Jehová? Ciertamente el obedecer es mejor que los sacrificios, y el prestar atención que el seno de los carneros.
Samuel said, hath the Lord has great delight in burnt offerings and sacrifices, as in obeying the voice of the Lord? Behold, to obey is better than sacrifice, and to hearken than the fat of rams.
Hagamos una oración. Padre celestial, venimos delante de su presencia. Le damos honra, gloria y alabanza, porque para siempre es su misericordia y su verdad. Queremos, Padre, que en esta noche sea su Santo Espíritu, a través de mi boca, Padre, hablando a cada corazón. Quiero ser, Padre, el portador y el vaso que usted quiere usar en esta noche. Santifique cada oído, santifique cada mente, santifique cada corazón, para que su palabra haga el efecto que usted ha preparado en esta noche para cada uno de los que estamos aquí. En el nombre damos honra y gloria. Amén. Pueden tomar asiento. No vamos a predicar mucho, pero queremos compartir la palabra del Señor. Y el tema de esta noche es la obediencia. Y el profeta Samuel hacía una pregunta. Y la pregunta constituía. Dice, si Jehová tenía que, ¿qué hacía más contento a Dios?
What would make God more, happy?
El que a una persona le obedeciera.
That one person to obey.
O que le pudiera traer alguna ofrenda de sacrificio.
That person to bring something to the sacrifice.
Y esta es una pregunta muy importante.
And it is a very important question.
Porque muchas veces.
Because many times.
Nosotros hacemos sacrificios.
We do sacrifices.
Que los hacemos de corazón.
That we do with our heart.
Hacemos sacrificios.
We do sacrifices.
Donde tratamos de someter nuestra voluntad.
Where we try to submit our will.
Para tratar de que Dios tenga contentamiento.
To try and make God happy.
Mas sin embargo la Biblia dice.
But the Bible says.
Y hace la pregunta.
And ask the question.
¿Qué es más importante para Dios?
What is more important to God?
¿Qué le agrada a Dios más?
What makes God happy? That you obey him,
o que usted traiga un sacrificio,
or that you bring a sacrifice to him.
Y dice el profeta Samuel,
and prophet Samuel says,
ciertamente el obedecer,
behold, to obey,
es mejor,
is better,
que los sacrificios,
than sacrifice.
Dice es mejor,
is better,
el prestar atención,
to pay attention,
a la voluntad de Dios,
to the will of God.
Es mejor,
is better,
el poner atención,
to pay attention,
a
what the word of God says. Better than anything else. Better than any sacrifice that you can present to God.
Y para poder entrar en más profundidad.
And to go into more profound.
Para poder entonces ver la importancia de
you see the importance of it.
Yo quiero que invitarle que hablamos en el libro de Hebreos.
I want you to go to the book of Hebrews.
En el capítulo 5.
Chapter 5.
Y vamos a leer el versículo del 5 al 9.
We're going to read on verse 5 to 9.
Y el mayor ejemplo que nosotros
Hebrews chapter 5,
versículo del 5 al 9.
Verse 5 to 9.
Y tomando entonces este ejemplo,
and taking this example,
este ejemplo sobrepasa todo.
This example overtakes anything.
Cualquier sacrificio,
any other sacrifice,
que usted haya hecho en su vida,
that you have done in your life.
Probablemente actualmente,
or maybe nowadays,
usted haciendo un sacrificio,
you're doing a sacrifice.
Tal vez está orando,
or maybe you're praying.
A una forma que usted dice aunque le cueste estoy orando.
To a way that you're saying even if it costs you, you're still praying.
Estoy ayunando.
I'm fasting.
Estoy esforzándome.
I'm making an effort.
Estoy tratando de escuchar música cristiana.
I'm trying to listen to the Christian music.
Estoy tratando de que mis palabras no salgan cosas ofensivas.
I'm trying to not speak any offensive words.
Tal vez haciendo sacrificios en este momento.
Maybe you're doing sacrifices right now.
Sin embargo, hay un elemento esencial.
But there is an essential element.
Algo de suma importancia.
Something really important.
Que usted no está obedeciendo.
That you're not obeying. Seven to nine.
El libro de Gálatas. Hablando de la Galatians chapter 5, verse 7 to 9. Y el apóstol Pablo declara lo siguiente.
The next.
Dice, porque nosotros, por el Espíritu, esperamos la esperanza de la justicia por la fe. Galatians chapter 5, sorry, verse 7. Dice, vosotros, versículo 7, vosotros.
Yeah, he did run.
Dice, corráis bien.
Run well.
Fíjese bien, corráis bien.
Look, this is
es decir,
well.
Andemos.
Let's be.
Caminemos.
Let's walk.
Como debe ser.
How we should.
Andemos.
Let's be.
Como un cristiano verdadero.
Like a real Christian.
Como un hijo de Dios.
Like a son of God.
Como un miembro de la iglesia.
Like a member of the church.
Dice, andemos.
Let's be.
Como debe.
How we should.
Yo quiero ser algo real.
Started to complain.
Diciendo,
ay,
eso no está bien.
the test comes,
ignoramos,
and we ignore
los propósitos de Dios,
we ignore the purpose of God,
empezamos a quejarnos,
and we start to
decimos, Señor,
complain and say, God,
si yo estoy orando,
if I'm crying,
si yo estoy ayunando,
if I'm praying,
si yo estoy viniendo a la iglesia,
if I'm coming to church,
si yo asisto a los servicios de hogar,
if I go to the they didn't have no water. Under the altar. Or we don't even want to come. We want to sit down where we're at.
And
you start praying and saying, Lord, look at my necessity.
And you
cry and you give
me a heart.
But nothing happens. Everything's the same. But sometimes the answer of God is so simple.
Que Pablo y Silas
Paul and Silas.
Dice que andaban predicando.
They were preaching the word of God.
Andaban haciendo milagros.
They were doing miracles.
Todo era perfecto.
Everything was perfect.
Todo iba en armonía.
Everything was in harmony.
Muchas veces.
Many times.
Todo en armonía en nuestra vida.
Everything is harmony in our life.
De repente vino el trabajo que quería.
And all of a sudden it's the job you wanted.
De repente agarró la casa que quería.
Maybe the house you wanted.
O de repente recibió el cheque que quería.
Or you received the check you were waiting for.
O de repente yo no sé.
Or I don't know.
Todo va bien.
Everything is perfect.
Pero de repente viene la
prueba. But all of a sudden there's a test.
El momento que usted no lo espera.
The moment that you were not waiting for.
El momento que usted sentía que estaba más cerca de Dios.
The moment that you thought you were the closest
to God. El momento que usted cree que ahora sí está obedeciendo a Dios.
The moment you thought you were obeying God.
Y de repente viene la tribulación.
And then the test comes. Tribulation.
Dice la Biblia que llegó la tribulación a Pablo y a Silas.
The Bible says the tribulation came to Paul.
Dice que no solamente los agarraron.
That not only did they get him.
Dice que los golpearon.
But they beat him.
Los golpearon feamente.
They beat him awfully.
Y los aventaron a la cárcel.
And they threw him into jail. And they threatened them
que los iban a matar.
That they were going to kill them.
Imagínese.
Imagine
que de repente la tribulación iba a subir.
That all of a sudden tribulation comes to your life.
No lo golpea.
Maybe physically you don't get beat.
Pero golpea su fe.
But they beat your
golpea faith. Lo que usted cree.
They beat what you
golpea
believe.
Lo que usted está tratando de hacer.
They beat from what you're trying
se
to
se
do.
Desarmado.
You feel
unarmed. Se siente que no tiene cómo pelear.
You feel like you don't have any other way to fight. But very little, you know.
Silas
in the middle of the test.
Dice que estaban en la cárcel.
Says they were in jail.
Dice que estaban orando.
They were praying.
Yo imagino que ellos oraban.
And you imagine they were praying.
Decía, Señor,
they say, Lord,
fortalecenos.
Strengthen us.
Señor,
Lord,
libéranos. Libéranos.
Free us. Give us the freedom.
Pon tu mano poderosa.
Put your strong arm. And they were singing
hymns.
They were singing hymns.
Hallelujah.
The hymn for
the
Lord.
You
see your soul.
La Biblia nos enseña.
The Bible teaches
us.
That not only we should sing with songs.
Sino que también cantemos con himnos.
But also with hymns. Because that makes the God's ear very happy.
Pero dice que en ese momento,
in that moment,
imagínese usted,
imagine yourself.
Usted viene a la iglesia,
you come to church.
Usted le brava su life,
you cry.
Usted busca una salida,
you look for an exit.
Se siente usted presionado,
and you feel pressure.
Pero de repente algo ocurre,
but all of a sudden something happens.
Como Pablo y Silas,
like Pablo and Silas.
Dice que de repente vino un terremoto.
All of a sudden there was an earthquake.
Dice que fue tan fuerte.
It was so
sacudido.
It shook the place. And all the doors. From all the cells. They opened. Can you imagine yourself? That Paul. And the heart of Silas. What they said. This is the answer of God. Because only God made the place. Only God opened the cells. We were able to leave. Let's leave. Let's go ready. This is the response of God. And sometimes there's an exit that is the easiest one to present it, and you take it and you say but God gave it to me. Nobody has
a
job. Everybody's here.
Oh, alabado sea el Señor.
you wait. Do you say, Lord, confirm your answer. I want to do your will. I don't want to do my will. I want the will of the Father. And the Bible says that Paul, going close to the key holder, the jailkeeper, and he tells him, what should I do so I can be he couldn't believe it that these men, after he beat them, after he tortured them, they didn't go out running. They stayed there, right there. And then after he was saved,
in that moment he took them to their
home and he healed their
wounds.
And he was
he repented
of hurting the sons of God, and his whole house received salvation. Not only the jailkeeper, but his whole house. And they go back to the jail. And the next day, the notice comes to the jailkeeper. There's no more charges against Paul and Silas. Let them go. Leave in peace. The response of God. It's not how you want it. It's not the easy exit. It's not the one that's harder. The growth of the spiritual growth. It's the one that costs you the most. To mold your body to the obedience of God. The one that grown will to the will of God. That's the response. They were in incomplete disbelief.
Complete
submission to God. Jesus Christ submitted himself completely to the Father.
Paul and
Silas.
No siendo muy diferente, José y Ana. Nadie too much different between you and me. Se sometió completamente a la voluntad de Dios.
They submitted themselves completely to God. Please stand.